This is 2018 R4i SDHC Dual Core Flash Card. I will show you how to install custom firmware on your 3DS using the NTR boot method utilizing this flash card. First of all, as always, I would like to say big thank you to 3dsflashcard.com for sending me this flash card to review. You guys rocks! So make sure you guys check their website later. I have put the link in the description below. So let's unbox this flash card and see what we got. This is the flash card. And this is the USB micro SD card reader. Now before doing anything, we will do some steps to avoid your console from getting banned from the Nintendo network. Open the system settings. You can see that this console is running stock firmware 11.6. Choose internet settings. Then choose spot pass. Choose the automatic software downloads and disable it. Then disable the sending of system information. Then you can close the system settings. Then open the friend list. Choose settings. Choose friend notification settings. And choose no for show friend what you are playing. Then you can exit the friend list. You can turn off the console for now. Let's try inserting the flash card to the console. Notice that I didn't insert a micro SD card to the flash card. You can see the flash card icon on the home screen. Let's try loading the flash card. You will see this error screen. It means that you are running the flash card without a micro SD card, and the flash card cannot find the kernel inside that micro SD card. Press the home button and close it. You will be back at the home screen. Turn off the console. Remove the flash card and the console's micro SD card. This is the micro SD card or the SD card that came with the console when you first bought it. And as I said earlier, you will need to add another micro SD card for the flash card to follow this guide. Now we need to download the flash card kernel. Open this URL. And choose the R4i SDHC Dual Core Flash Card. Choose the kernel language that fits your need and download it. Finally, you need to download the NTR boot package. Go to this URL and download it. Now insert the console's and the flash card's micro SD card to the computer. This is the flash card kernel. And this is the NTR boot package. This is the console's micro SD card. And this is the flash card's micro SD card. Open the NTR boot package with WinRAR. There are 4 folders inside it. Navigate to the console's SD card root and drag all its content to the console's SD card. Then navigate to two flash card SD card root and drag the .nds file to the flash card's micro SD card. Then open the R4i kernel archive and drag all its content to the flash card's micro SD card. Remove both micro SD card from your computer. Insert the flash card's micro SD card to the flash card. Then insert the console's micro SD card and the flash card into the console. Now load the flash card. Choose the gamepad icon. Then run the ds-ntrbootflasher.nds file. Ignore the warning and press A to continue. Now press the up and down button to select the correct flash card. We should choose R4i SD8C family for the flash card type. Press A to confirm, and then press A again to eject ntrboot hex, and then press A again to select retail. It will take some time to process. Please be patient. Then press A to continue, and then press B to exit the ntrboot flasher. Then power off the console. Then turn on the console. You won't see the flashcard icon on the home screen. It is normal because you have injected the ntrboot hex to the flashcard. Now prepare a magnet. We will find a sweet spot to make the console sleep. You can use any kind of magnet as long as it is enough to trigger the sleep function. Place the magnet near the ABXY button. If both screens turn black, it means you have triggered the sleep function, and you have found the sweet spot. Find the correct sweet spot and remember it. I think I have found it right here. I can turn the screen off consistently. Now turn off the console. Place the magnet on the sweet spot. Now press and hold X, start and select button, followed by pressing the power button. When done correctly, you will see the Safe B9S installer screen. You can move the magnet aside if you like. Now enter the given combo keys to install the custom firmware. It will take a couple of seconds to process. At this stage, you should force the power of the console by pressing and holding the power button, or else the console will boot loop into the screen indefinitely. Now remove the console's micro SD card. Leave the flash card in its slot. Insert the console's flash card into the computer, and open the ntrboot package. Navigate to the latest Luma3ds folder and drag the boot.firm file to the root of the console's SD card, replacing the existing boot.firm file. Then navigate to the flash card restore folder and open the 2 SD card root folder and drag all its content to the root of the console's SD card. Now go back and enter the flash ROM folder and open the R4i SDHC dual core folder and drag all its content to the ntrboot folder of the console's SD card. Then open the ntrboot folder and rename the backup.bin file to R4i SDHC-backup.bin. Remove the micro SD card from the computer. Reinsert the micro SD card to the console. Soon after turning on the console, you will see the Luma3ds configuration screen. Press the down button and select A to select show NAND or user string in system settings. Make sure you see the X mark inside the parentheses. Then press start to reboot the console. Go to the system settings. you can see that there is a sys prefix in front of the firmware version. It means that the console is already running custom firmware on system NAND. You may exit the system settings for now. Now open the download play app. We need to modify each function to be a homebrew launcher temporarily. Press and hold L, down, and select button to open the Rosalina menu. Select miscellaneous options. Then choose switch the HV title to the current app. Then press B several times to exit the Rosalina menu. Now close the download play app. Then reopen the download play app. You will see the homebrew launcher. Find FBI app and run it. Navigate to SD and then enter the CIIS folder. Select the current directory and choose install and delete all CIIS. Press any key to continue, then press the home button and close the FBI app. Then you can unwrap all the newly installed titles. Now run the DSP1 app. And then press B to install and automatically delete itself. Run the Luma 3DS updater to see whether there is a new version to download. As I made this video, the latest Luma 3DS is version 9.0, so you cannot download anything yet. Press start to exit the Luma 3DS updater. Now you can try updating the console firmware. Go to the system settings to check it out. Choose other settings. Then press the right arrow until you see the system update button. As I made this video, the latest firmware for 3DS is version 11.6, so you cannot download anything yet. Now turn off the console. Press and hold start and power button, and select the NTR boot flasher. We will restore the flashcard functionality to its original state. Ignore the warning screen and press A to continue. Use the R4i SDHC family. And select Restore Flash. It will take some time to process. Please be patient. Then press A to return to the main menu. Choose power off. Then again, press and hold start and power button to enter Luma 3DS chain loader screen. This time, choose GUT mod 9. Press the home button and choose scripts. Choose backup sysnan. It is mandatory to backup the system NAND for safety measures. Make sure you have at least 2 GB of space left on your SD card or else you will fail to backup the system NAND. Then press A to continue. Press the home button again and choose scripts. This time choose setup CTRNAND Luma 3DS. This script will copy the Luma 3DS to the CTRNAND partition, so you can boot the console without inserting the SD card. Follow the on-screen instruction, enter the given combo keys and relock the NAND. Finally, press the home button again and choose scripts, and this time choose cleanup SD card. This script will delete all the unusable content inside the SD card. Then press start to reboot the console. The flashcard icon is back on the home screen. And you have completed the guide to install custom firmware on your console with NTR boot method utilizing the R4i SDHC dual core flashcard. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you like it. Please subscribe for more upcoming videos.